When you go to Google and type in climate change is, you're going to see different results depending on where you live and the particular things that Google knows about your interests.
That's not by accident, that's a design technique.
What I want people to know is that everything they're doing online is being watched, is being tracked. Every single action you take is carefully monitored and recorded.
A lot of people think Google's just a search box and Facebook's just a place to see what my friends are doing. What they don't realize is there's entire teams of engineers whose job is to use your psychology against you.
I was the co-inventor of the Facebook like button.
I was the president of Pinterest.
Google.
Twitter.
Instagram.
There were meaningful changes happening around the world because of these platforms.
I think we were naive about the flip side of that coin.
You get rewarded by hearts, likes, thumbs up, and we conflate that with value and we conflate it with truth.
A whole generation is more anxious, more depressed.
I always felt like fundamentally it was a force for good. I don't know if I feel that way anymore.
Facebook discovered that they were able to affect real world behavior and emotions without ever triggering the user's awareness. They are completely clueless.
Fake news spreads 6 times faster than true news. We're being bombarded with rumors.
Everyone's entitled to their own facts. There's really no need for people to come together. In fact, there's really no need for people to interact.
We have less control over who we are and what we really believe.
If you want to control the population of your country, there has never been a tool as effective as Facebook.
We built these things and we have a responsibility to change it. The intention could be, how do we make the world better?
If technology creates mass chaos, loneliness, more polarization, more election hacking, more inability to focus on the real issues, we're toast.
This is checkmate on humanity.